Guys, Cobb Tuesday, Pipe Week. How are y'all doing? Yes, I'm in the garage today for a couple of reasons. They're having a party next door, and it is obnoxiously loud, and the dogs behind me on this side are barking accordingly. I don't think my microphone could cut out enough to have a decent video. So, all right, what do we have in the Cobb today? Well, took a little short break from Carter Hall, and I'm having half and half. Well, you didn't think I was going to leave out half and half for very long, did you? So, Cobb Tuesday, Pipe Week. Let's talk corn cob pipes. So this is a Missouri Meerschaum Legend. Okay. And I'm going to show you off my corn cob collection. Corn cob collection. Say that 10 times fast. But I'm going to give you a little quick backstory with me and corn cobs. I hated corn cobs for a long, long, long time. I thought they smoked horrible. The taste in them was like burning insects to me. Super nasty. I could also taste the stain. So this is a plastered cob for you guys that may be new. So literally what they do is they take the corn cob off the cob. They cut it. Drill it out, and then they'll put plaster through here, and then they'll put a I believe this is a yellow or clear stain, yellow stain on it. And oftentimes I have found in my tenure that stain will get into the bowl, and oftentimes when you light the pipe the first time, you can taste that stain, and that was that kind of like, I say insecty because it tasted like a chemical, just nastiness. Anyway, and so I typically shied away from cobs because once I had my first one years ago, I didn't like the taste. I found that every time I went back to the cob to try whatever blend in, it would just taste like crap. And I had my Peterson Kinzel XL20, which was my main pipe that I had, along with one other Peterson pipe, system pipe. And I was like, oh, the blends that I love taste great in there, but why do they taste bad in here? So I just kind of forgot about it. Well, fast forward maybe 2 years, and I found what's called a naked cob, or naked cob. And that is like this one. So you see how it's rough versus that. So there is no plaster or anything on the outside of this. And we'll go into the details of that in just a second, but that tasted better to me. It did have a little bit of a corn taste when you first lit it up, but it didn't have that same nasty chemical shaitan type of taste. It was ugh. Anyway, so if you guys are newer, or if you've tried cobs and you're like, ugh, it tastes tastes crap. There's a little solution. Fast forward a few more years later, I'm now all in the YTPC and making friends and things like that. And a guy told me, he said, you need to really char up the inside of your cob. And I'm like, char up the inside of my cob? What are you talking about? And he's like, yeah. He's like, take a torch lighter or whatever, and literally just burn the inside of it. And he said, the thing is you'll burn that stain off because the stain can taste pretty bad. And he said, I think there's a gray stain, and I don't have any, ooh, I just scratched my mic, I'm sure. I don't think I have any cobs that are gray stained. That's your typical country gentleman's, I believe. Try not to hit my, I'm looking in here. I don't think I have any. But apparently the gray stain doesn't taste as bad as the yellow stain. So your mileage may vary. I don't know that. But after I burned off, really charred the inside of my cobs, especially the plaster ones, I found that that taste went away and I could enjoy the cob again. And they do smoke a little sweeter and a little drier. I have to admit that. And if you're a filter guy, the filter filters a little bit more, and it's a pretty darn good smoke, in my opinion. Now, do I reach for a cob all the time? No, but they do now have a place in my rotation. And I also keep extra cobs around just for if I ever meet anyone who wants to try pipe smoking, or if my friends or friend comes over, whatever, and they've forgotten their pipe, which if you've watched my channel for any length of time, namely my buddy Hondo, always forgets his pipe. And so I have an extra one on hand for him. And I bought a bunch when they were like $6, so they're nothing really. But they are a handy utilitarian pipe. The other thing is, I don't tend to do a lot of activities while I smoke. I sit down, I enjoy my smoke, I want to taste the flavors and things like that, do a video with you guys, contemplate the world, whatever. But I know a lot of guys like these if they're hiking, driving, cutting the grass, whatever. Because if you drop it and break it, it's not a big deal. So, in honor of Pipe Week, I thought I would show off my cord and cob stash. Oh, I also got my hardwood in here. Well, one of my hardwoods. I just realized, as I said that, I left my other one downstairs. But box of corn cobs. So, again, I don't think you can have too many corn cobs. There is also, and I haven't taken advantage of this sale, so if you're new, again, Missouri Meerschaum does a smokable seconds line where they have little flaws and stuff. And Parsimonious Piper is a big fan of them. I have never purchased them, but I do believe that you can get like a bag of them for like $20 or $30. And I think there's 8 or 9 in a bag, maybe. Someone correct me, please, all by all means. But so they're really affordable. Okay. And I talk. Hold on. Let me get my pipe lit and I'll show you these. Ooh, that's the thing. Cobs will make certain aspects of blends shine more than others. And I think one of the reasons I like the cob now so much, once I got over the stain taste and all that, is that for burley blends, it really makes that peanut butter burley nuttiness shine in it. And it's just, I got a good hit of that. Okay. So this guy. I have had one smoke out of this guy. It is a naked cob. See, no stain. It is a General. This is what General MacArthur would have smoked. The thing is massive. You can use it as a hammer. I wanted to smoke Harkness in it, for what he had, but I haven't ordered any Harkness in a while. It is a very good blend though, and I may have to do that now that I'm talking to y'all, but this is so deep. The bowl goes all the way down to here. So my finger won't get all the way down to the bottom. But if you guys because most cobs are a little on the smaller side, and I know some guys have complained about that. You cannot complain about this one. This is the MacArthur General, I believe. Five star, maybe. Five star is what they call it. Anyway, that's the first one. Coming up, this little guy. So these two are tied for my favorite style. They're kind of a poker style, okay? This one is the Legend, which they, I believe, was one of the first styles that they ever made, and they sell the best of. This is a Missouri Pride, okay? Now, this is well-smoked. I love this one a whole lot. I would say these are equal as far as smoking and everything. The only thing the only reason I would give this a leg up is the stain that comes on this. In my opinion, you got to burn it off. This didn't have any of that. So you'll just get a kind of, like I said, like a little corny, a little bit of burning wood if you go all the way down to the bottom where the shank goes into the bowl. And let's see if I can get, you can kind of see it right there. It goes all the way into the bowl. Here is I believe this is a Rob Roy. There you can see how the shank goes all the way down. I have not smoked this. This is a bent. So they're bent pipes or not really bent pipes, guys. They're just kind of semi-bent. So they hang like this. You can really, hold it like that. So I guess that's your bent pipe. But it's a nice kind of almost Dublin style because it kind of the conical bowl comes down. Very nice. Again, naked. Most of mine are going to be naked. I am a big fan of nakedness. Mark Twain. Again, loved this pipe. Dublin style. Pretty good bowl. Thicker walls for a corn cob, as opposed to, say, the Missouri Pride. So this is a very classic, timeless cob. Country Gentleman. Again, naked. Now, I will say I'll give a ding on the naked ones. If you have a pipe pouch that is lined with and I haven't smoked this one either, lined with felt or flannel, which is mine, and you put one of these in there, it's gonna pick up the lint of it. Whereas with this, it's smooth, so it's not gonna pick up any of the lint. Oh, this is a General, I think. So this is the five star, I think. And then this is just a regular General. But again, guys, I mean, look at that. Has a little bit of that Danish stem on there. I think that's kind of cool. They're a little thicker than these. I chew the heck out of these because, I mean, they're like $5. Not even that, maybe. They used to be a dollar. They're probably $5 now, but anyway. Yeah, so I'm barely touching the bottom now. But big, big cob. Let's see here. Another Missouri Pride. Never been smoked. Okay. What is this guy? Okay, this is a bent Missouri Pride. I told you that was probably my favorite shape. Another Legend. Ooh. What's this like? Oh, that's the other thing. Show you the Legend here. There will be subtle differences too. Based on growing years, they are a natural product, right? I have to say that's the other thing. The naked ones are a lot lighter. These are kind of heavy. I mean, it does feel like you're holding a little bit of plaster in the bottom of your, or at the end of your mouth, you know? Let's see. Another straight Rob Roy. Kind of with the Danish stem there. Again, unsmoked. Another Missouri Pride. Did I get them all? Nope. Oh, look. Oh, yeah. Another Missouri Pride that I have smoked. And that's funny. That's a longer one. This is another legend, but look at the length. So they had a longer shank on this one. You see that? Oh, it's a thinner shank too. Huh. I'm just now. Let's see, this one I'm smoking. Okay, so it's comparable. Interesting. I just noticed that. Huh. And then, last but not least, before I show you the rest, there's a hardwood. Piper Ken got me stuck on these hardwood pipes. And I really do like these. And I will tell you guys, if you haven't seen that video, if you want, let's say you own a cob, and you're like, I like the way cobs smoke. They're good. But you don't really have, let's just say, $40 or $50 for a estate pipe, or like, you know, even $40, $50 for a Graybo, Dr. Graybo now, which is a briar pipe. These are around, I think, $10 or $12. And they look a little nicer than a cob. You know, they have that briar look. This is it escapes the old noggin again. It's a hardwood, cherry maybe. Maybe this is maple. This might be maple. But anyway, they smoke wonderful. I cannot complain about these. These are workhorses. I have abused, I have this one and I have another one, and I've abused both of these pretty bad, and they just take a licking and keep on ticking, man. I might even argue a little better than the corn cobs. And then last but not least, I went and purchased a whole bunch of extra stems. I enjoy the white stems just because I like change of pace. Okay, so I got a bunch of the white stems. Here's some of the black stems. One of the bent amber stems, because you know your stems break, or you're like me and you chew through them. So, but yeah, so that's for the love of the corn cob pipe on Cob Tuesday, pipe week. Long video. Hope you stayed with me. If you did, then you may or may not know about the first video I did yesterday. We're going to be having a giveaway, and I think I'm going to do multiple giveaways. All going to be on Friday. So we're going to do, yesterday was Medico Monday, today's Cobb Tuesday, tomorrow is going to be William DeMuth Wednesday, so I'll show off my William DeMuth pipes, Thermo Filter Thursday, and Artisan Pipe Friday, and then we'll do the giveaway on that video, with a couple of them. I think I'm just going to draw some random names. So all of you guys that have commented on that first video, you get an entry already. So, all right, guys, I'm going to enjoy the rest of my half and half while I listen to the dogs barking and the kids screaming, and we'll see you tomorrow. Take care.